glioblastoma is the most common malignant brain tumor. It's one for which, despite now decades of research, we really don't have effective therapy for. Why is it more likely that a male will develop glioblastoma? Why is it more likely that they'll respond less well to therapy? Because in understanding that, it would be our hope that we would develop some insight into how to tailor treatments and improve outcomes for everybody. The magnitude of the difference in response between male and female patients can be measured in two ways. One is the response to therapy, where females exhibit a significant response to therapy in terms of tumors getting smaller, and males do not. And the other is in survival, and females survive on the order of just months longer than males, but significant. We found that survival in male and female patients seemed to be driven by very different molecular pathways. In the males, it was all about regulating cell division, and in the females, it seemed to be about regulating invasiveness. For me, among the most exciting things about this study is the way that it might impact on clinical care. Personalized medicine to date has primarily been about, if I can tell what's wrong with your tumor, I can design a therapy just for you. But it hasn't yet incorporated the idea that males and females are different. Our hope is that these findings will change the way that doctors think about treating glioblastoma and other cancers in a male-specific and a female-specific way. It's our expectation that doing that would improve outcomes for everybody.